In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your domain inside of Systeme.io. All right, we're inside of the dashboard. You're going to go down to, well, hover over your face or your name or whatever in the top right. Go to settings. Once you go to settings, you scroll down, you'll see custom domains. If you don't already have a domain, you're going to have to go purchase a domain. I usually recommend Namecheap. Usually they have a cheap domain name offering, and they don't try to sell you a bunch of different services. Usually you can find domains for under $10. So they are my recommended domain provider. I've been using them for over 10 years, so I like, know, and trust them with all of my domains. So I would recommend Namecheap. But once you have your domain, you're going to hit add domain. Okay, I am inside my Namecheap. I found a domain that I want to use. And I'm going to enter that domain in here. Make sure there are no spaces before or after. And I'm going to hit save. They said the domain must begin with www or another subdomain, which I don't like www, but it's whatever. So add www and hit save. Now we're waiting on this thing to load. It should give me the settings that I need to put in. So we have the www. So we're gonna go to the DNS configurations. If you're inside of Namecheap, you want to switch it back to your basic Namecheap DNS. That means DNS is being managed by Namecheap. The reason you're doing that is because when you go over to advanced DNS, you can make your settings from here. So they said that they want me, let me close this one. It said sixpaydays.com, so www is going to go. I already have a CNAME for www, so I want it to go to this particular area. So you copy the whole thing and you paste it in the value section here. You want to set this to automatic, and then you hit the check mark. So the first one is done. So the www is www.sixpaydays.com. That's what this is basically saying. You don't need to copy the whole thing, just the www. And we're going to go do it again. So I just need the first part that is in front of the dot. We're going to copy that. Come down here. We want a CNAME. We want to make sure that is there. And then the value is going to be this entire thing right here. So I'm going to copy that, paste it in there, make sure it's automatic, and hit save. So both of these should be saved. It don't seem like they're saving. Okay. It took a little while, but both of these are saved, so it should work. Now, I'm going to give you just one more. When you put a CNAME record and use the at sign, that means it's going to go back to the main URL, which is sixpaydays.com. So I want to put that in there to where, actually, I'm going to do www. I'm going to use www just because that's how it's set up on the software. But personally, I don't like www. It is 2022. We all know it's a World Wide Web. But this at symbol says whatever they put in, if they put in the wrong URL, it should still go back to the main URL. So all of that is done. So I've added it. Let me see, 6 paydays. You have exceeded the limits of your plan. Blah, blah, blah. So my domain should show up here, but it's not. Let's see. Okay, so it's pending validation. So let's see, show instructions. I've read the instructions. So we're waiting on this pending validation. Once it's done, it'll say ready to use, and I'll have this check mark. But for right now, we're just waiting on that. Let's check my mail settings. That is still pending as well. So after we made those changes, we added a new domain. We have to wait on the validation. It shouldn't take all day to do the validation, it is a new software, so we shall see. But that is how you set up a new domain.